We had a great one. I actually made a 21-pound turkey for 4 people. So I have a lot of turkey left over, as most of you probably do as well. And most people don't like eating it the next day because it tends to be dry and you're bored. So even if you want to have a little regular turkey tonight and then tomorrow you're looking at it again and you're like, what the heck am I going to do with this? I have the most amazing recipe. It's our turkey cranberry wreath, which is so delicious and it makes use of your leftover turkey. So I'm preparing it on the round stone, and I'll post the recipe in the comments, so don't worry about writing anything down. I'm making it on the round stone, which makes it a wreath, and I'll show you with the crescent rolls. But if you have the bar pan, it can really be just like a braid. So don't worry about the shape of it. And that's Barkley. He wants to go out, so hang on. We're going to let him out, okay? Never fail. It's just like a little kid. You get on the phone. They need you. I make a video. Barkley wants to go outside. All good. Okay. So let me tell you what's in this. So this is 2 cups of cooked turkey. I use white meat. If you have dark meat, you can certainly use that as well. I have in here 2 cups of craisins. We have some chopped up celery. We have some fresh parsley. There's some fresh pepper. There's some honey mustard. Some 2 cups of shredded Swiss cheese. And then some mayonnaise. Super easy. And don't worry, I'll post the recipe. And what I'm doing now is I'm using the large scoop, but before I actually show you the scooping process, I just want to show you what I did with the crescent rolls. When you open up a can of crescent rolls, they're triangles, so you just separate them, and if you're using the round stone, the wide sides go in and the points hang over. And listen, guys, if this wasn't Thanksgiving or if you don't like turkey, I fill this with spinach, feta, and artichoke, a chicken broccoli ring. You could do a taco ring for your kids. Anything you stuff in crescent rolls is a win-win in my book. Okay, so for this, we laid out the crescent roll triangles. You're going to overlap them because you want them to overlap, and then you're going to push down so they all kind of seam in together. You could use the dough roller, but I'm a little lazy, and I'm not. I'm just squashing them down with my hands. And then I'm going to take the large scoop of whatever mixture you're using. This is the turkey cranberry, but you can do spinach, feta, artichoke, taco, whatever your family likes. And you're going to put a scoop on each one of the large part of the triangle. The point is hanging over, and the wide part of the triangle is facing inward, and that's where each scoop goes. Now, if you're saying, she's got an awful lot of batter, I do, because I'm making 2 of these. One to give to my daughter and one for my family. So don't get nervous when you think your batter is not nearly as full as mine was. This is double. So look, oh my God, I wish you guys could smell how delicious this smells. Absolutely scrumptious. And I'm telling you, you bake it at 375 on the low rack of the oven. And here's my trick when you're working with crescent rolls, if you're not familiar with them. They look like they're done. They're like a nice light golden brown. You always want to leave crescent rolls a few minutes longer. You want to get a real golden brown because that'll make sure that it's cooked all the way through. In my early Pampered Chef days, 24 years, spending this month, happy anniversary to me, there were many times I pulled it out thinking it was done, and then as I was cutting into it, the crescent rolls were a little gooey and raw underneath. So you don't want that. So you definitely want it to be a nice, rich golden. Okay, so that is it. Do you see, guys, how it's just scooped? I feel like I have a little extra because I'm known to always make more of anything that I'm cooking. So let me fill a little bit more. But, yep, that's all we're doing. And then I have a whitewash. You never want to use the egg wash. You want to use the egg whitewash because, believe it or not, you get a much nicer glisten on the top, much nicer shine if you use the egg white than the actual egg yolk. Okay, so now look how easy. Look what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this point, and I'm just going to tuck it under. You can't screw this up, guys. It's so easy. Just tuck it under, just like that. Then you drip out, under.
Tucking it right under.
And then I wish that I had like sesame seeds or something that I could sprinkle on top of the egg white wash, but I searched in my pantry and I don't. So when I go to the supermarket this week, I need to pick that up. Okay. So we're tucking it in.
Looking good.
And then I have a little prep bowl with my pastry brush, and it's a white wash, not an egg yolk wash. You get a much nicer shine, kind of glistens when you pull it out. And you can put sesame seeds on top. You can throw some grated cheese on top. I don't really like grated cheese with the turkey, but I guess you could. I always use the grated cheese when I do the spinach feta and artichoke. Take one also, please. Yeah, you want to be my kid, Jennifer. Yeah. You definitely want to be one of my children. They got a good deal going on. Okay, so that is it. I'm going to bake that in the oven, 375, and it's good to go. So hopefully if you have leftover turkey and you just don't know what to do with it, and by day two or three or even four you're tired of looking at it, I'll post the recipe, go pick up the crescent rolls, the other simple ingredients that you need, and it is a great lunch, it is a great dinner, and it's super delicious. Okay? Thanks, guys. Have a great rest of your day and a fabulous weekend.